हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर एस बी कोल्ले, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फिजिक्स, शिवाजी आर्ट्स कॉमर्स एंड साइंस कॉलेज कन्नड़, डिस्ट्रिक्ट औरंगाबाद। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस चेंज ऑफ एंट्रोपी इन रिवर्सिबल प्रोसेस। सो स्टूडेंट्स, कंसिडर कंप्लीट रिवर्सिबल साइकिल शोन बाय दिस फिगर ए बी सी डी। हियर इज द कार्नोट साइकिल, रिवर्सिबल साइकिल। सो हियर वर्किंग सब्सटेंस इज आइडियल गैस। नो फ्रेंड्स, ए टू बी इज आइसोथर्मल एक्सपांशन and B to C is adiabatic expansion, C to D is isothermal compression, D to A is adiabatic compression. So these are the four steps for this complete Carnot cycle ABCD. Now we will see one by one. First take step, isothermal expansion A to B. So here Q1 quantity of heat absorbed by working substance during this isothermal expansion from A to B at constant temperature T1. It is shown in the diagram. Now here from A to B expansion, it is isothermal expansion. Here increase in entropy in this case is integration A to B dS is equal to plus Q1 upon T1. Now friends, here the working substance has absorbed Q1 amount of heat. So its entropy will increase. So it is shown by this plus sign, plus Q1 upon T1. Now second step, adiabatic expansion BC. Here there will be no change in entropy, but temperature will fall from T1 to T2. Here, adiabatic expansion, no heat can leave the system or no heat can enter the system. So Q is zero, so entropy is zero. So change in entropy for this adiabatic expansion is integration B to C is dS is equal to zero. Now take third step, isothermal compression C to D. Here Q2 amount of heat is ejected to sink by working substance during this isothermal compression at constant temperature T2. Now friends, integration C to D dS is equal to minus Q2 upon T2. Q2 amount of heat is ejected to sink. Here so minus sign. Now adiabatic compression dA, fourth step of this cycle. Here also there will be no change in entropy because adiabatic compression, again no heat can enter the system, no heat can leave the system, but temperature rises as it is adiabatic compression. Temperature will rise from T2 to T1. So change in entropy in this case is given by integration D to A dS is zero. Now if we have to calculate net gain entropy, then we have to add this all entropies from all these steps, four steps. So net gain in entropy is A to B integration dS plus integration B to C dS plus integration of C to D dS plus integration of dS from D to A. So total change in entropy for this whole cycle ABCD is given by this sign of this integration is equal to Q1 upon T1 minus Q2 upon T2, because from B to C and from D to A the entropies are zero, change in entropy is zero. So remaining is Q1 upon T1 minus Q2 upon T2. For reversible cycle friends, Q1 upon T1 is equal to Q2 upon T2. Again we can say Q1 upon T1 minus Q2 upon T2 is zero. So putting this in this complete cycle integration means for this integration over the whole cycle of dS, if we put here Q1 upon T1 minus Q2 upon T2 is zero, then we can say entropy remains constant in reversible process because change in entropy is zero. So obviously entropy remains constant for this whole reversible process, for this whole cycle. Reference I use for preparation of this PowerPoint presentation. Thank you.